celebrating 45 years of broadcasting.
Come on!
The voice of Nassau Community College.
I love this station.
90.3 WHPC.
WHPC HD Garden City.
Available on the iHeartRadio app.
The opinions expressed on air are not necessarily those of WHPC, its management, or Nassau Community College.
Responsible opposing viewpoints will be considered by emailing them to whpc@ncc.edu or by mail to WHPC 1 Education Drive, Garden City, New York, 11530.
Thanks for listening to the voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC.
Welcome to another edition of From the Press Box right here on 90.3 WHPC, the voice of Nassau Community College. My name is Rob Leonard. Thank you for joining us. And on the phone with us, because he's not feeling that well, is my co-host, award-winning sports writer Tim Leonard. Hello, brother. How are you?
I'm injured.
From what?
I fell.
From doing what?
I was walking on a set of stairs at a retailer that will remain anonymous, and the stairs were of the corrugated metal variety.
Okay.
And the building is so old that the sections of the stairs have been worn away. Now, it was wet the other day after all the snow and whatnot, and I must have hit some water or something and fell backwards on the stairs.
Okay.
So I'm all bruised up. My elbow is all swollen up. I got bruises on my back, among other places. So, okay. I'm convinced that the only reason I don't have a concussion is because I had my backpack on my back, and that absorbed some of the blow.
Okay.
And I think probably prevented me from hitting my head on the steps as well as the numerous other body parts that have been injured.
Okay, well, I hope you're better.
Thank you, brother. I appreciate that.
Yeah, I care. I'm your brother. I'm your older brother. I'm supposed to look out for you.
Yes. Tell me something, brother. What was with that music?
That was Herb Albert and the Tijuana Brass, baby.
Was there any reason that you played that?
Because why not?
Oh, all right.
It's green. The song is called Green Peppers.
Okay.
So it's not a bad thing. I don't like green peppers. God knows I hate
either.
The smell. And but it's good music. Herb Albert rocks. You know.
If you say so.
He does. He does. By the way, we wish our mom a happy birthday. She turned a certain age on Friday, and happy birthday to mom. I don't know if she's listening, but she normally doesn't. But
she at some point, probably a decade or so ago, became younger than us.
I don't know about that, but...
No, she did.
How'd that happen?
You just ask her how old she is. She'll tell you.
Oh, yeah. Well, she gets angry when I tell people how old she is. Because people say, wow, your mom looks great.
Yeah.
And she does.
She does.
But, everyone, I say, well, she's so-and-so. I'm, oh, don't say that. Don't say that. Let them think what they want.
Don't talk about my age.
Yeah, okay. As long as he's still standing straight, that's all that matters.
So, happy birthday, Mother.
Yes, happy birthday, Mother. Anyway, brother, lots of things happened this week. First of all, we should say, as happened a few times after this show ends, there was major sports news last Monday. Now, I don't want to spend too much time on it because it's already passed, but we should mention, because this happens enough times, that Ben McAdoo and Jerry Reese were both fired on the same day at the same time by the New York Giants. And I have to say that John Mara, stood up and basically said, yeah, well, it was kind of my fault about Eli. Even though we know it was Jerry Reese, really, who was not Jerry Reese, Bob McAdoo, Ben McAdoo, sort of pushed it. But John Mara, you know, the stand-up guy he is, I guess, said, well, I agreed to it, so it's my fault. Which is, in a way, true, because he is co-owner of the team.
Well, I mean, he had to say that.
Of course.
And we talked about this last week. In fact, I remember saying that, you know, this is one of the reasons that I thought that McAdoo and as it turns out, Reese, would be fired last Monday. And that part, a big part of that was damage control, because they had no idea how unpopular the move to bench Eli Manning would be.
Right.
And so what happens if you're looking to turn around a bad PR situation, well, what do? You give the fans what they want. And in this case, that what the fans wanted was Ben McAdoo out and Jerry Reese out. And they wanted somebody to pay for what is now a 2-11 season.
Well, someone had to be sacrificed, and it was those two.
Rightfully so, I think. Also, yeah. I mean, I'm not saying that they were somehow fired unjustly. Both men are a big reason as far as why the Giants are here right now. But as far as the benching of Eli, hey, John Mara was involved in that decision as well. But when have you ever seen an owner get fired?
Never.
Never, exactly.
Because the Wilpons would have been fired a long time ago.
You got it, baby.
So the Giants lost the Cowboys yesterday. Eli started, but it doesn't matter. That's the problem. It doesn't matter that he starts, because this team is going absolutely nowhere. Not even a couple of wins at the end of the season just to give hope for next season. It's just a bad thing going on right now with the Giants.
Well, you saw yesterday what has pretty much become the Giants' standard this season. They were in the game for a little while, and they played three fairly decent quarters, but the offense couldn't do anything, and eventually they kind of gave the game away late. The Cowboys scored 20. It was 10-10, and the Cowboys scored 20 points in the fourth quarter. So what are you going to do when your team isn't doing anything, can't move the ball? And I mean, you know, it was nice yesterday that the fans at MetLife Stadium got to give Eli the proper sending off that they wanted to be able to give him.
Right.
Eli got a standing ovation yesterday, and you know, the fans wanted to be able to salute him in that way.
Now, we should say that next week is Philadelphia at Giants, so we should say that.
Right. I mean, it's not like there aren't more home games.
Right.
But the fact of the matter is that now that the fans have been able to salute Eli the way they wanted to, and you know, that was part of it. Was I think that the fans kind of thought, part of the anger was that the fans thought that, all right, well, our quarterback, the guy that we've been rooting for you know, 15 years or however many years it is, he's on his way out, and we're not going to get the chance to, you know, kind of thank him in that way.
Right.
Well, now that they've been able to do that, you know, I'm sorry, but we have to go back to the fact that Davis Webb needs to start for this team now. And the franchise needs to find out what they have in this kid. Otherwise, he basically becomes a wasted draft pick. Because the Giants need to take a quarterback. Yesterday, the Giants strengthened their hold on the number two overall pick, because the 49ers won, and the 49ers are actually showing everybody, hey, look at what we can do with a decent quarterback. Because Jimmy Garoppolo, the guy who they got from the New England Patriots, he started the last couple of games, and the 49ers have looked reasonable. You know, they've looked decent. This is a bad team, but you see what a quality quarterback can do for a bad team. And I'm not saying that Eli is no longer a quality quarterback, because the Giants have had so many injuries this season that I don't know that anybody could do anything with this team. But the 49ers were dreadful all season. And Garoppolo has started, the last three games, I believe it is, and the 49ers have won two of them.
Mm.
So now they are 3-10, I believe it is, and the Giants 2-11, and Cleveland Browns are still winless even though they went to overtime yesterday with the Green Bay Packers, but managed to blow that game as well. But that's, you know, that's where we're at right now, is that the Giants are pretty much now a lock for the number two pick, because I don't think they're going to win another game. But
well, you know, did you mention Indianapolis?
Yeah, they're in there too. Yeah, but they're three and ten. Yeah. So if the Giants, they're right now, it's the Colts and the 49ers for the number three pick, whatever that tiebreaker becomes. But the Giants at this moment don't need to deal with a tiebreaker.
No,
they have the second worst record in football, free and clear. Now again, I don't think they're going to win another game. So even though next week with the Eagles, you know, we're looking at a situation where Carson Wentz suffered a knee injury yesterday. The thinking is that it was an ACL injury, and he's going to have an MRI today to determine the severity of it. But chances are that he's got a torn ACL, and he's going to be done not only for this season, but probably for a good portion of next season as well.
Really?
So I mean, an ACL is a year. So, and especially in the NFL, you don't want to rush back from an injury like that, because if you do, you're playing on a weakened knee, and you know it's not like the 300 pounders are going to take it easy on him.
That's true.
So you don't want to rip the thing up again and have to have another surgery because you rushed back. You know, I mean, I've done enough ACL stories in my life that. People think that you can rehab, like you can rehab your way through the injury after the surgery, but you can't. You know, you could, if you're just a regular person, you could do that. You know, if you're really kind of dogged about your rehabilitation, and you know you're in the gym and you're working your knee and doing all your exercises, you could make it so that you would be quote unquote healthy after, let's say, 7 months. But surgeons have told me that the reason why an ACL is a year is because all of the blood flow needs to return to 100% in the knee, and you can't rehab that. That's nature. That's your own body that needs to kind of heal itself in that regard. And make it so that the blood flow is back to 100%. So that can't be done in a gym. That's just done by waiting, and you can't speed that up. So if I'm an NFL player, especially when you have, you know, when you're first of all getting hit violently, and B, when you have guys up to 350 pounds jumping on you, I'm not coming back early from that. I mean, the risk of re-injury is just too great. And again, I mean, this is the kind of an injury where if it happens again, you're out a year. And again, I mean, it's there's no way around it. So, you know, it better to come back and know you're 100% than to, you know, try and rush it and come back after, let's say, 8 months or 9 months or whatever, and, you know, do it all over again. I mean, because a lot of times what will happen is if you have the injury, sometimes the other knee will pop because, I don't know, it's kind of a body's way of balancing it out somehow. Or you could also re-injure the original injury. So it's not a good situation for Philadelphia, which has been having a great season. But, you know, I still don't think the Giants are going to, you know, steal a win next week.
No, it would be nice, especially at home, but we most likely not going to happen. We're going to take a break right now, brother. When we get back, we'll quickly talk about the Jets. We got to talk about the Yankees because they
did that was the big story of the week.
That was two big stories for the Yankees. So we will talk about that when we get back. You're listening to From the Press Box right here on 90.3 WHPC, the voice of Nassau Community College. Also, later on Spreaker.com, it becomes a podcast. And currently, right now, as all of WHPC is, it's on the iHeartRadio app. Just do a search of WHPC.
Yo, what happened to your hair?
You have to experience what I just experienced.
What'd you do? Stick your finger in an electric outlet or something?
Close. I just listened to Electric Air.
Electric Air?
Electric Air.
Can